Live UP dates show van, who has pleaded not guilty, is facing multiple murder charges. Last updated, March 29, 2021, 3:54 p.m. ET. The trial for Derek Chauvin, the former Minneapolis police officer charged in the death of George Floyd, begins Monday in Minneapolis. He faces charges of manslaughter, second-degree murder and third-degree murder. The trial is expected to last 4 weeks. Alicia Euler, a shift manager for the Speedway located across the street from Cup Foods, first noticed police officers messing with someone when she began watching the encounter involving Floyd, she told prosecutors Monday. Euler took 7 separate video recordings on her cell phone but could not immediately recall details, stating that it had been so long. During a cross-examination, defense attorney Eric Nelson walked 911 dispatcher Jenna Scurry through the timeline of the encounter and pressed her on her knowledge of Minneapolis police use of force policies. Nelson seemed to want the jury to know that Scurry was not familiar with how police handled such incidents. Scurry acknowledged that she has only seen police incidents play out live on monitors in the dispatch center 3 to 4 times in the 7 years she has been a dispatcher. ABC News' Whitney Lloyd contributed to this report. Jenna Scurry, the Minneapolis 911 dispatcher, told the court she had a gut instinct that something was wrong. Scurry said she continued to take calls but noticed that the squad car in front of the Cup Foods did not have officers surrounding it. The next time Scurry looked up, she saw the officers placing Floyd in the back of the car. Scurry said she later knew something might be wrong when she saw Floyd on the ground. When Assistant Minnesota Attorney General Matthew Frank asked what made her think something was amiss, Scurry said dispatchers rarely see videos of active scenes on those cameras. Moreover, the fact that Floyd went from the back of the squad car to the ground and officers had not requested additional assistance worried her, Scurry said. I took that instinct and called the sergeant, who supervises police officers, she said. Court recessed for lunch after Frank was done questioning Scurry. Jenna Scurry, a 911 dispatcher who watched Floyd's encounter with police unfold on a fixed police camera, was the first witness to take the stand Monday. Scurry began by explaining the tools she utilizes to do her job. She said dispatchers have access to cameras that are placed around the city,